immigration. The clarity, the difference between an immigrant and an illegal alien is comparable to the difference between a house guest and a burglar. The United States has the most generous immigration policies in the world. For 30 years, I worked for the former INS. For half of my career, I was assigned to the Drug Task Force. We admit roughly 1 million lawful immigrants into the United States each and every year. That is more than the rest of the world combined. And for clarity and truth and full disclosure, I'm first generation American. My mom, may she rest in peace, came here ahead of the Holocaust. I was named for my grandmother, who was slaughtered in Poland by the Nazis. I'm a registered Democrat, but I can't tell you the last time I voted for a Democrat. But the Republicans don't have much to be proud of either. This is not about left or right. This is about right or wrong. It is about the globalists versus the populists. The United States of America was founded by populists. Thomas Jefferson began the Declaration of Independence with those three super important words, "We the people." We the people. And today, campaign contributions, which are nothing more than thinly veiled bribes, have given the special interest groups, have given the U.S. Chamber of Commerce, have given the American Immigration Lawyers Association the best government money can buy for them, not for us. And the point that we are losing here is that by not making a clear distinction between lawful immigrants and illegal aliens, is that we are humiliating and disgracing legal immigrants who come to America properly to share their lives and their dreams with us. But we have the power, and we saw it this past November. Any mayor who sponsors a sanctuary city needs to lose that job that they have. Sanctuaries do not provide sanctuaries for law-abiding citizens. They provide sanctuaries for criminals, terrorists, fugitives, and those people who would come here and displace American workers. If you're truly behind the American dream, then we need to secure our borders against illegal immigration. We need to make certain that visas for workers are never issued to foreign workers who displace American workers. We need to recognize that our first and our last line of defense are the borders of the United States of America.
That wall must be built.
But we must understand that we are a nation of 50 border states. Any state that has an international airport, any state that lies along our 95,000 miles of meandering coastline, any state that lies along the northern and our southern borders are all border states. And when people run the border, they're not undocumented, they are unvetted. They enter without inspection. And if you look at the 9/11 Commission, first and foremost, not only 9/11, but other terror attacks were made possible by multiple failures of the immigration system. And yet, you have mayors, especially Mayor de Blasio here in New York City. Any documents to illegal aliens. Now think about it. Bad guys want false ID. Isn't it terrible how you guys are lackadaisical and don't have spirit? Look, we have to make a clear understanding here. Providing illegal aliens with identity documents is the equivalent of providing camouflage to people who would hurt us. We don't know who they are. We don't know why they're here. We have a registry for sex offenders to keep sex offenders away from our kids. Yet we have millions of people in this country right now who ran our borders because they did not want to be screened. The categories of aliens who are supposed to be kept out of the United States has absolutely nothing, nothing to do with race, nothing to do with religion, nothing to do with ethnicity. And I will tell you, if it was about that, I could not have been an agent. Those laws are about keeping out aliens who have dangerous communicable diseases. Ellis Island, I remind you, was a quarantine station. Aliens who are mentally ill, or criminals, or spies, or terrorists, or human rights violators, or fugitives from justice, or would likely become a public charge, or if they worked, would displace American workers. How on earth can any politician who claims to represent America and Americans not understand the intrinsic and essential nature of our borders and our immigration laws? They cannot be faithful to their oaths of office, and they certainly don't represent we the people. It is estimated that 7,000 innocent people, many of whom, by the way, live within the ethnic immigrant communities, lose their lives to illegal aliens every single year. How in the world is it pro-immigrant to provide criminals the opportunity to live within the ethnic immigrant communities? And this is not just about Latin America. The Russian mob, Asian organized crime, the Jamaican drug posses, the Israeli mob, I don't care where. People are people are people. Every race, every religion, every ethnicity has the good, the bad, and the ugly. We need to welcome the good, but make damn sure we don't wind up getting the bad and the ugly. All I ask is keep up your enthusiasm. Make the politicians accountable. That is our job. We are their employers, and those who support sanctuary cities are insubordinate to their employers, us. I'll put in a quick shameless plug. If you go to my website, I do a lot of emails. I do a lot of articles for websites. MichaelCutler.net is my website. But ever since 9/11, you know, I testified before Congress 4.5 years before 9/11 because of the two terror attacks carried out in the United States in 93. An individual from Pakistan attacked the CIA in January 93, killed two CIA officers, wounded three others. We had the first bombing at the World Trade Center. And you would have thought that we would have learned the lesson. I was called to testify before the House Immigration Subcommittee on May the 20th, 1997, on the issue of visa fraud and immigration fraud, because that's how the terrorists were getting in. And guess what? The Clinton administration did nothing. Guess what? The Bush administration created DHS in such a way that made it impossible to enforce the immigration laws. I have come to call DHS the Department of Homeland Surrender. However, we finally have a president in the Oval Office who understands the significance of our borders, who understands the need to put Americans to work, who understands the need to combat transnational gangs, drug trafficking organizations, and international terrorists. Every rational American should be out here cheering, not only for the president, but should be cheering for those few members, unfortunately, in Congress, irrespective of party, who support his actions. We need to support our Attorney General, Jeff Sessions. In 2007, when they tried to ram comprehensive immigration reform down our throats, led by Chuck Schumer, Schumer, the guy who said in 2014 that when people trespass on landmarks and critical infrastructure, they should be put in jail for 5 years. He wanted to make it a federal crime. And he even talked about a 16-year-old kid who, being a 16-year-old kid, climbed the top of the Trade Center to take a selfie. In Schumer's world, that kid should be in jail for 5 years for trespass. But in Schumer world, when aliens trespass on America, we should give them citizenship. Does the hypocrisy get any worse? Now, in 2007, I did a bunch of hearings as an expert witness before the House and Senate on comprehensive reform, and I wrote an article for the Washington Times. Senator Sessions liked it so much, he quoted me on three separate occasions from the floor of the Senate during the debate. Are you ready for the name I gave comprehensive immigration reform? I called it the Terrorist Assistance and Facilitation Act of 2007. This is about common sense. This is about sticking up for our fellow Americans. And when I hear people compare illegal immigration and the battle being waged by the anarchists, and by the way, we're not anti-immigrant, we're pro-enforcement, but when they keep on talking about civil rights, it's an insult to American blacks. The civil rights movement, long overdue, came about to address the inequities, the unfairness, not only of slavery, but that which followed after slavery. What in the world does that have to do with illegal aliens? Why is the Black Caucus not standing with Black Americans? Is that an unreasonable question? Folks, you need to ask that question. And if it doesn't matter how you come here, why do we bother inspecting passengers and cargo at international airports? Why are we spending $14 billion plus a year on customs and border protection? An alien who runs the border doesn't get less legal the further he or she gets from the border. When a guy robs a bank, they don't tell the cops if he runs out of the bank, don't chase him. Right? If you run the border, you're not less illegal by coming to New York. And by the way, guess what municipality has the greatest number of illegal aliens? Right here, folks. 1.2 million, according to the most recent estimate. And I don't doubt that some of them have been attracted to come here because of Mayor de Blasio's sanctuary policies. But please make this clear in your own mind. We are not helping people in third world countries by exploiting their citizens in the United States. Make that point clear in your mind. We have become the escape valve, the safety valve for Mexico and other third world countries that seek to export their citizens so they can send dollars back home, so they don't have to worry about taking care of them within their own borders. Mexico has the 16th largest economy in the world. Carlos Slim, at one point, was the wealthiest man in the world. Born in Mexico, educated in Mexico, worked in Mexico, but then he bought into the New York Times. You wonder why their editorial policies went the way they went? We're not helping Mexicans by allowing their people to come here to be exploited. I've raided sweatshops in the beginning of my career before I went on to do work on terrorism and narcotics. The conditions under which illegal aliens are forced to work is disgusting. They are the victims of the corruption of their government, and they are the victims of the corruption of our government, working in cahoots with those corrupt governments of third world countries. We need to take a stand against it. We need to get our voices heard. And I thank all of you for being here today. God bless America.
We have a gentleman here who wants to say a few words. Jimmy McMillan. Come here, Jim.